here with Jeff Holder and Chris Keating. Both of these guys are fantastic people here at the Galena Canning Company. Jeff Holder, you are Director of Operations, and Chris, you're Director of Manufacturing. And you guys manufacture and you make all of these amazing items that we have in front of us. You know, Jeff, let's start with you. Tell me a little bit about the Galena Canning Company.
Sure, I'd be happy to, Nathan. So I came to Galena in 1990. About 93, I was in the Galena River Wine and Cheese shop, and over in a corner was this huge gregarious guy by the name of Chef Ivo, and he was hawking his wares. And that's the first time I met Chef, and come to find out that he was a master chef, trained at the American Institute of Culinary Arts in New York and in Paris.
Jeez.
He was the executive chef for the Board of Trade in Chicago.
Wow.
And he was trading it all in to come out to Galena and start this company. So what happened was, he had a cookbook from his grandmother. So he's a first generation.
Wow.
From the, she was from Estonia, okay? And he took his skills and her recipes, and he started to develop the items that he was producing and selling at the Galena Farmers Market.
Okay.
And that was what officially launched the Galena Canning Company.
Yeah, Galena Canning Company. You guys have been around since 1993 and just produce a lot of different items. And I'm ready to jump in. You know, we're going to test my limits a little bit today. So let's. I love a good Bloody Mary. You got a wonderful Bloody Mary kit. Let's jump in with this guy.
Chris, why don't you explain what we got cooking here?
This actually is a Bloody Mary mix we've been making for over 20 years. We did ours a little bit different. We don't like all the fruits and vegetables to sink to the bottom, so we made it nice and thick. Okay. It's got a lot of ingredients inside there. We rimmed it today. We actually used the dill pickle hot sauce, and then we used our bacon rimmer. Add a little extra flavor to it, and we threw a little bit extra of that hot sauce inside there as well. We also garnished it with a few of our pickled items. We used our asparagus, our bread and butter pickles, and then our bread and butter pickled jalapenos.
But this is a wonderful, light, full-flavored Bloody Mary, and that's really good.
So we get most of our fruits and vegetables that we make all of our salsas, barbecue sauces, other items and stuff from as local as we can. Obviously, nobody's growing mangoes up here, so we got to get them outsourced. But we use a lot of local farmers. We use a lot of co-ops and stuff like that. Ingredients come in. As soon as they come in, they are processed and put into a jar within 24 hours.
Well, we're going to give you a little break.
Okay.
Okay.
Good.
We're going to start with some of our Fruit salsas. Right. So these are going to be very easy on the palate. It's a summertime favorite. Obviously, you can dig in deep with the chips, but they go great on chicken and pork. Mm. You don't just need to let it sit for your chips.
But really great fruit flavors. I mean, just really super strong, and that lovely blend of sweet heat. It's always fun. I always enjoy it. So Chef Ivo, I mean, he's a pretty incredible person. He's no longer with us, unfortunately, correct? Yeah, yeah, but this continues on in his legacy and his grandmother's legacy as well.
Exactly. So Chef Ivo passed a year ago. Two people very, very close to him personally. And we felt compelled to carry on his legacy. And we're going to stay true to form with the recipes and all the great ingredients that go in. You know, he said it best, he wants bold flavors with timeless tastes. Barbecue sauces are one of our highlights. We've got a hickory apple barbecue sauce, our number one seller for 20 years. Then we've got all the sauces that you just tried. We've got jams, jellies, preserves, pickled items. We've got mustards,
wow,
salad dressings.
Grilling sauces,
but we also have
hot sauces.
Okay. You guys are known for your hot sauces, correct?
Absolutely. We have quite a few, yeah. So we have anything from extremely mild to you might have to call the paramedics. We'll start with the mango habanero. This is going to have your sweet citrus flavor right on the beginning, and then it's going to slowly start bringing up the heat in the back end. Anything seafood, pork, chicken wings, you name it. You can throw that stuff on there and it's just perfect.
No, but that's good. I mean, I'd love to see that on some chicken wings or something like that. I'm sure that's really, really excellent.
Now, the second one we're gonna have you try, this is our fire roasted habanero. This is kind of our all around perfect sauce that can literally go on anything from your eggs in the morning for breakfast, pizza at night, chicken wings, nachos, everything in between.
It's definitely on the range of Midwest hot.
You got it right, Midwest hot. Yeah.
This is Midwest hot. Yeah. Now, we're taking it up.
This is the first hot sauce that we ever made. It's got a really cool design on the bottle and everything. Galena used to be an old lead mining town. We actually, Chef Ivo actually found these bottles and they kind of look like sticks of dynamite.
Yeah.
So when he was going to make a really, really knock your socks off, really taste good kind of sauce, he's like, it's gotta be a stick of dynamite and call it blasting sauce. Originally, we stopped at Red Savinia Habaneros, but over the years it's progressed.
Okay.
So we started with the ghost peppers when they came out, and then when the scorpion peppers came out, we started putting those in there. Then the Carolina Reapers started going in there, and now there's
all of that's in here.
It's all in there.
All right, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna pop this in and see what happens here.
All right. So you're gonna get a nice smoky flavor right at the beginning, good garlic undertones, and then the pepper flavors all start kind of coming, and it's gonna build.
Boom, 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 boom.
Yeah. All 26 are gonna hit you at different times.
It's like stacking. It's yeah. Like it's really like a stacking of pepper on pepper on pepper on pepper.
It's kind of like a brick wall.
Right. That's hot.
But the flavor, you almost want to take another chip and go in.
That is still, but it's a very flavorful hot sauce. I'm with you here.
You going double down?
Yeah, that is.
We do have the fruit salsas that you can also do to cool down if it gets too much.
It is spicy. My mouth is on fire. I am starting to sweat, but the flavors are there. Guys, thanks so much for having us in. Everything's been incredible. Woo! I'm gonna be feeling this for a little bit.
Tearing up a little bit, yeah.
Woo! But everything's been absolutely excellent, and thanks for having us in.
Thank you, Nathan.
Hey, thanks for stopping by.